Hey guys, welcome to me reacting to SpongeBob Conspiracy number 6, the Goofy Goober Alien Death Cult Theory by Alex Bale. Now, I have not seen this, but dang, what an interesting title, I'd say. And my best guess is that his prediction is that the Goofy Goober Peanut Thing Club is actually... they're aliens? Maybe? I don't know. It would make sense. I don't really know. I really don't know. I'm thinking of a SpongeBob fan game where in the game there are aliens, like Jellians, and they use the Goofy Goober establishment as their like breeding ground, but I don't think that's gonna come into the video at all. If you know what video game I'm talking about, it's like... I think it's... is it 6 o'clock in Bikini Bottom? I think that's what it's called or whatever. I don't really remember. It's a time and then in Bikini Bottom or something. I don't know. I know it's made by the same person who made 3 a.m. At the Krusty Krab. But, yeah, anyways, guys. We're using some description. Make sure to be Alex Bale. Thanks. Social description. Or is this getting right into it?
That's right. You read the title correctly. This is the Goofy Goober Alien Death Cult Theory, and no, I am not joking. This seemingly innocent ice cream parlor is a front for something very sinister. The beloved SpongeBob movie actually has a much darker and tragic meaning to it. I am
really
100% serious when I
that would make sense though.
I think this is my best, most convincing theory.
The last theory was the Neptune theory.
If you thought my evolution theory was dark, well, get ready. This is the Goofy Goober Alien Death Cult Theory.
Okay, I'm ready. Yeah, the evolution theory was a little bit dark. Sandy Cheeks is a spy. What the? Snakes yawn? I didn't even know that. Wait, what? Oh yeah, I forgot there's a story to this. How could I forget? Well, I forgot to mention that. I knew there always was. So is this like...
hey, what's the...
okay, so that's perfect.
Oh boy, Alex has finally lost his mind.
Ooh. Okay, I'm gonna pause it there. That is definitely something relating to the story. That is definitely something relating to the story. And that is very interesting. That has to do something with, like, whole story and how there's, like, this... because if you don't know, if you haven't watched the past conspiracy theories, which you definitely should, you definitely should. There's an end credit scene at every single time, and there's this looming figure that seems like very big. I have a theory on who it is. I think it might be like some amalgamation of all the SpongeBob characters. And my best guess is that when maybe this has to relate to the whole story with, like, him going to a pet shop and then getting that animal, and then the animal gives him the theories or something, maybe like that. But I love what the story is and the message and how it's, like, all about the fact that the theories have kind of taken over his channel, and basically what he's been wanting to doing with, like, the whole horror thing, he kind of added that to this because he knows that this is taking over the channel. So it's honestly very cool, and I love when channels kind of add that message, because I do think that is a big problem with when it comes to, like, YouTube and all that, when it's like one thing takes over the channel and it's not really, like, the thing that you really want to be doing, but hey, you're doing it anyways. And I genuinely love that message a lot.
Goofy Goober Alien Death Cult Theory? What, did he make that in a random word generator? Trust me, there's actually a lot to this theory. And if anyone's qualified to
make it, it's me, just joking.
Considering I made a whole web series about a restaurant being a front for a cult.
Here at Pizza Time Pizza, we don't use any preservatives or fake ingredients.
Pizza Time Pizza is not a cult.
What the heck?
Those are the old days. I'm the SpongeBob guy now, and there is an insane demand for more of these theories.
Literally proving what I said earlier.
12 million views. That is crazy. Thank you guys so much. Now let's begin the theory. Goofy Goofy Goobers is an old-fashioned ice cream parlor that first appeared in the SpongeBob movie. It's the very definition of a fun, innocent place for children.
Yeah.
So, how on earth did I come to the conclusion that it's actually an alien death cult? In fact, what even is an alien death cult?
Yeah.
Usually, it's a religious group that wants you to believe that one day aliens will come to Earth and take the members of the cult to a better place. And in order to get there, they have to commit mass suicide. The most infamous example of this being Heaven's Gate. Like I said, this is going to be a very dark video with some serious subject matter.
Okay.
How does this have anything to do with Goofy Goobers? In the more recent seasons of SpongeBob, they've started referencing Goofy Goobers again. In fact, there's even an episode called The Goofy Newbie where Patrick gets a job there. And it's in this episode, when Patrick is watching an employee training video, that I first realized there was something more going on here.
Oh, I think I might have seen this.
Our story begins with our founder, Reginald Goober, who for some unexplained reason was nicknamed Goofy. In 1842, he headed west in a covered ice cream wagon. He served his warm ice cream on rocks and sticks. From those humble beginnings, Goofy Goober has grown into a multi-billion dollar business.
You know, it's a pretty standard company video.
Okay.
They just want their employees to wash their hands and keep their work area clean.
We only ask that you, one, practice good hygiene, two, maintain good work habits.
Nothing out of the ordinary, except there's one more thing that they want you to do.
And three, believe in extraterrestrials.
Yeah. Yeah, what?
Huh. An organization that wants you to believe in aliens.
Okay.
That could be a Heaven's Gate reference in SpongeBob, could it? No, that's crazy. And even if it was, it could just be a random throwaway gag. There's no way Goofy Goobers is actually a cult, right? But then I started to rewatch every appearance of Goofy Goobers, and things took on a whole new meaning.
Really?
One of the most basic ideas of a cult is that they strip you of your individuality and make you change your entire identity to be about the cult. And that's exactly what Goofy Goobers does. Everyone there wears Goofy Goober uniforms just like a cult. I mean, what other restaurant has not just employees, but customers that always dress up in a specific way?
And that's actually kind of true.
That is constantly repeated and reinforced is just the simple line,
I'm a Goofy Goober, yeah. You're a Goofy Goober, yeah. We're all Goofy Goobers, yeah.
I'm a Goofy Goober, you're a Goofy Goober, we're all Goofy Goobers. It is literally just a song saying that your whole identity is based around Goofy Goobers.
That's an interesting
thought. And in the SpongeBob movie, there's a scene where SpongeBob and Patrick have to try their best to not sing along to the theme song, and it literally causes them intense pain to not sing along.
Mm. That's true.
They've been brainwashed and physically can't stop themselves from singing it. And you can't even just chalk this up to SpongeBob and Patrick being weirdos. Two other fish can't stop themselves from singing along, even though it means they'll get beat up for it.
Goofy, Goofy, Goober, Goobers, yeah!
And just like how many cults have an icon or god that they worship, Goofy Goobers has the dancing peanut mascot that's all over the restaurant's branding. I mean, just look at how excited all the kids are when he comes out.
Goofy Goober!
Yeah.
All right, but just because kids like a mascot doesn't mean that they have some kind of religious worship for them. Well, if you don't believe me, take it from SpongeBob himself.
Open your eyes, Patrick! We blow bubbles, we eat ice cream, we worship a dancing peanut for corn's sake!
We do not worship him!
Patrick, you've been wearing the same Goofy Goober peanut party underpants for 3 years straight! What do you call that?
Worship?
In the SpongeBob movie video game, there's even a Goofy Goober token that reads, "In Goofy We Trust," replacing the word God with Goofy. Things are looking awfully culty, aren't they? Cults will also often create reading material about their beliefs for their followers to read, and Goofy Goobers is no exception to this. In the new SpongeBob spin-off, The Patrick Star Show, we see a Goofy Goober employee reading some kind of book about ice cream. And look at him, he's not busy working, he's choosing to read this in his downtime. I mean, compare him to Squidward, who sometimes reads in his downtime at work. It's not like he's reading about a Krusty Krab. This book looks a lot like it's a doctrine for a cult's beliefs. A major part.
I will say that I feel like that's a little bit of a stretch. That is definitely a little bit of a stretch. And the main reason why is just because, one, it could be just a manual of how to do your job because the person's not good at it. But that's also an assumption. But not only that, the thing is about the Patrick Starr show is that it's very weird. And it really doesn't make much sense when it comes to the timeline and where it is. Because it really seems like this is an alternate universe. Like, the Patrick show seems like an alternate universe. And not really in the same universe. I mean, that's at least how I feel when I see it. Because it's like, a lot of things just don't line up. And a lot of characters look completely different. Which is very odd.
Of how cults get so successful is by getting their followers to give them money. Now, obviously, Goofy Goobers charges people for ice cream, but they actually convince their followers to trade their money for a made-up Goofy Goober currency.
I don't know what Plankton's paying you, but if you let us go, I can make it worth your while.
What is this?
That, sir, is 5 Goober dollars. Legal tender at any participating Goofy Goober.
This would explain how the Goofy
Goober dollars,
idiot who sold ice cream on rocks and sticks, turned the company into a multi-billion dollar franchise. He convinced people to believe that aliens would one day take them to a better place and got them to give him all their money. Another tactic that cults use to indoctrinate people is overloading them with compliments and making them feel special. And that's exactly what Goofy Goobers does to Patrick when he gets a job there. The tranny video says that they appreciate him.
Hello and welcome. As a new Goofy Goober employee, we'd like you to know that we appreciate you.
And then his manager says the exact same thing.
I'm your manager, and I want you to know that I appreciate you.
And then despite Patrick messing up and causing chaos, the manager says it once again.
I'll give you another chance tomorrow. If it doesn't work out, I'm afraid you're fired. In a most appreciative way.
There is no reason for the manager to be disappreciative of Patrick after the terrible work he's done. He's just trying to emotionally manipulate him. The tactic is especially effective on vulnerable people like children, and we see this in the Patrick Starr show. Not only did Patrick start eating Goofy Goober ice cream when he was young, and eventually ended up working there and worshipping their god, but this green kid also grew up to become... There's a clear pattern here. Kids who eat the ice cream all eventually
become
the cult. They are specifically
children
for indoctrination, but their manipulation goes far beyond just psychological tactics. Trust me, we've just scratched the surface of how far Goofy Goobers will go to brainwash its members. Things are about to get darker.
Wait, what? Ooh, okay. So now we're doing this during the theory. Oh, it's a cat. Oh! Oh my god, that's dark. Because I already know what that means. He's gonna feed the cat to the thing.
There's
Ooh,
a part
that's
in the SpongeBob movie where SpongeBob and Patrick go to Goofy Goober's
that's kinda
and
dark,
eat tons
actually.
Of ice cream all night to the point where they become completely drunk off of it. It's a really funny scene, but it begs the question, why does the ice cream get them drunk? Maybe that's just how ice cream works in the SpongeBob universe, and it's the show's way of making a family-friendly alcohol reference. But we've seen other instances where characters eat tons of ice cream and it doesn't have this effect on them. Alright, well, maybe this was just a one-time gag for the movie, and it's not a consistent part of the continuity. But in the season 11 episode, Call the Cops, we get this scene.
One too many Goofy Goobers again, eh, Patrick?
Oh, what?
Another deliberate reference to Goofy Goober ice cream having a weird alcoholic effect on people. Is it possible that they put something in the ice cream to make people more open to cult indoctrination? Cults have been known to use drugs to make their followers obedient and suggestible. One of the most infamous examples of this being Charles Manson, who used LSD to convince his followers of his beliefs. If this is the case with Goofy Goobers, they'd probably want to make sure everyone there eats as much ice cream as possible. And the Goofy Goober building is actually cleverly designed in a way to ensure that this happens. There are no windows in the entire building, so you can't tell whether it's day or night. And the Goofy Goober clock just has random numbers on it, so it's impossible to keep track of time. time. Because of this, SpongeBob eats ice cream all night and is actually late for work for the very first time. Also, can I point out the fact that the eyes on the clock seem to follow Patrick around in the Goofy Newbie?
It's what?
Creepy and specific detail to include. I mean, we know from the movie that the eyes are usually supposed to be looking straight ahead, but here, they're always watching Patrick, their next target for indoctrination.
Interesting.
Now, if the ice cream is what keeps their followers in line, they definitely want to make sure their employees were eating as much as possible. And it turns out, Goofy Goobers actually has a policy about this.
Oh, yeah.
Wow, I can't believe Goofy Goober's employees get to eat all the ice cream they want on this job.
The employees get to eat all the ice cream they want. Very interesting.
Yeah, that's interesting.
And there's evidence to suggest that the ice cream can do a lot more than just make you suggestible. At the beginning of the Goofy Newbie, Patrick is holding up the line asking for samples of ice cream. The employee he's talking to gets frustrated and calls for security to kick him out.
I would like you to use my spoon!
Security, we have a sample mooch at the counter.
But there's something oddly familiar about this employee. Hang on a second. Isn't that Patrick's sister? The new
what?
Spin-off, the Patrick
what?
Show is a prequel to the main show that introduces us to Patrick's little sister, Squidina. And here, we see her all grown up, working at Goofy Goober's. She's even credited as Squidina and has the same voice actor.
In
the
past,
we actually do see her eating Goofy Goober ice cream as a kid, which fits with the pattern of kids who eat the ice cream eventually getting indoctrinated into the cult. Now, Squidina and Patrick have a very close, loving relationship in the Patrick Star Show, but here, they act like they're total strangers. It's not surprising that Patrick would forget his own sister, but Squidina is always portrayed as being smart. It's almost like she completely forgot about him. One of the biggest tactics that cults use to indoctrinate people is isolating them from their friends and family to make them more vulnerable and dependent on the cult. And that's exactly what we're seeing here with Squidina. She has no memory of her family. The ice cream might just be affecting her memory as well. I mean,
she
was just meant to be some random reusable character here with no continuity. Why would the creators go out of their way to specifically credit her as Squidina, unlike the other random employees who are just credited as employee? Feels like
yeah, that's interesting.
To it. At the end of the Goofy
that night, is interesting.
Patrick goes crazy and eats a ton of the ice cream, and then the episode ends in a very interesting way.
Oh, alien! Yeah, yeah.
Peace, hugs, and ice cream.
Yeah.
Now, I don't think Patrick was actually abducted by aliens. I mean, we see him on Earth in the very next episode, and the UFO has the same fake look as the one
held by wires.
I think that because of all the ice cream he ate, he now fully accepts the Goofy Goober's beliefs, and it's caused him to hallucinate the UFO. So, at this point,
dang.
I'd say we can make a very strong case for Goofy Goober's being a cult, but with this realization comes a very dark and tragic new meaning for the SpongeBob movie. Believe
true.
Me, you will never look at that movie the same way again.
That's true. End credit scene? Okay, here we go. Yeah. Here we go. Of course, dark, so you don't see what it looks like. What's on the sweatshirt? That's probably his like actual cat. Ooh, okay, there's more. So I kind of like how like there's some story beats like during the theory.
The 2004 SpongeBob movie is my favorite thing to come out of the franchise. It's funny, it's emotional, and it encapsulates everything great about SpongeBob. In this movie, SpongeBob goes on a journey of self-discovery and realizes that he doesn't need to change who he is and grow up to fit into society. He just has to embrace his inner kid and be himself. It's a great message that feels really fitting for the character. But if you replace the word kid with Goofy Goober, SpongeBob's arc takes on a whole new meaning. It's not about SpongeBob embracing being himself. It's about SpongeBob fully accepting the indoctrination and beliefs of the
That's
Goofy
true!
Goober cult. The movie starts with SpongeBob not getting promoted to manager of the new Krusty Krab, a job that he desperately wanted and believed that he would get. When he finds out that Squidward got chosen instead of him, it completely destroys him. Cults will target vulnerable people who are at extremely low points, and the first place that SpongeBob goes to after having his heart broken is Goofy Goober's. After a night of getting drunk off of ice cream, he becomes resentful of Mr. Krabs and decides to tell him off.
I deserve that manager's job, but you didn't give it to me, because you say I'm a kid. Well, I am 100% man, and this man has got some.
In fact, if King Neptune didn't interrupt and try to kill Mr. Krabs, SpongeBob probably would have quit and been fully able to join the cult. SpongeBob and Patrick
Maybe.
Go on a quest to retrieve Neptune's crown, and it's almost like every obstacle they face along the way is specifically
the ice cream.
To make SpongeBob and Patrick realize the dark truth about Goofy Goobers, but they fail to do so at every turn. So, they first stop at this tough guy bar that's full of men who beat up anyone that isn't manly enough.
Yeah, I remember this.
But I think there's actually a lot more going on here than it seems. This place actually has an insane amount of similarities to the Goofy Goober ice cream parlor. They're both shaped like boats, they both have bikes out front and a bar inside, and they both have two word titles that start with the same letter, Goofy Goobers and Thug Tug. Is it possible that this place is actually a former Goofy Goobers establishment that was abandoned? I mean,
maybe.
They literally have the Goofy Goober theme song on hand.
SpongeBob, it's the Goofy Goober theme song!
And they claim that no kids are allowed here, yet we see some old kid-sized handprints in the bathroom. If this really is a former Goofy Goobers, then these guys would probably know the truth about the cult, which would explain why they're so against having anyone who's not manly in the bar. It's not because they hate kids, it's because they're trying to keep out a dangerous cult. If SpongeBob and Patrick just stuck around a little longer, maybe they would have learned this too, but they quickly sneak out and even make fun of the tough guys at the bar.
Come on, Pat, one more time.
Okay. We're on a baby hunt. I don't think we don't know how to wee.
Clearly, they didn't get the lesson they were supposed to from this place. Then they go through a fish graveyard and stop at a random ice cream. But it turns out it was actually a trap for a monster to lure unsuspecting victims.
Okay, Patrick, you can let go now.
An ice cream store that's a facade for something darker that lures people in and keeps them trapped. It's like the ocean is literally
screaming
to SpongeBob and Patrick.
That's actually kind of crazy.
They just aren't getting it. But then they reach an obstacle that's just too great for them to pass, and it makes them reevaluate some things about themselves.
We're not kids.
Open your eyes, Patrick.
Yeah.
We worship a dancing peanut for corn's sake. You've been wearing the same Goofy Goober peanut party underpants for 3 years.
Oh, yeah, then they change. Yeah.
It isn't until Mindy helps them realize that they're more than just Goofy Goober kids that they can continue on their journey. They sing an entire song about how they believe in themselves now, and Patrick even says this.
Yeah, he changes.
Now that we're men.
I changed my underwear.
They have finally broken free from the cult indoctrination.
Interesting.
But unfortunately, it doesn't last very long. They're stopped by a hitman Plankton hired to take them out, and he completely destroys all the progress they've made to grow as characters.
Step aside, and you won't have to feel the awesome wrath of our mustache.
Awesome.
These.
They were fake?
Of course they were fake!
They end up getting abducted by a scuba diver, who, to them, is a terrifying alien from another world, which is an interesting parallel to Reginald Goober being taken by aliens.
Yeah, that's interesting.
They're taken to Shell City in a room full of dead fish, a place eerily similar to a death cult after a mass suicide. While SpongeBob and Patrick are being dried to
death,
they
actually
decide to
really
fully
dark.
Embrace the Goofy Goober's beliefs and spend their last moments alive singing the Goofy Goober theme song.
I'm a Goofy Goober, yeah.
Yeah, wait, holy crap, yeah.
Goofy.
But then, just like death cults always promise, they and everyone in the room are reborn when the sprinkler system turns on.
Oh, I like how that goes with the music. That's actually kind of crazy.
Whew, it's getting real dark. Then we get to the climactic finale of the movie.
Oh, well, yeah.
SpongeBob returns to the Krusty Krab, now a changed man. He has to battle Plankton and his army of mind-controlled slaves, and this is how the final confrontation plays out.
Yeah, I'm a goofy goober.
Anything during that time, it's that you are who you are.
So yeah, I'm a kid, and I'm also a goofball, and a wingnut, and a knucklehead McSpazzatron.
What's going on here?
But most of all, I'm...
Hey, settle down.
I'm...
Take it easy.
Yeah.
What the scallop?
I'm a goofy goober.
I'm a goofy goober.
Yeah.
On first watch, this is such a satisfying and cathartic moment.
Yeah, wow.
But in reality, this is the moment that he has gone past the point of no return and becomes a goofy goober.
Yep.
Now, this is normally when I pretend like the video was over and then surprise you with a last minute twist, but I don't need to pretend this time. If you think this entire video has been insane rambling and none of this could possibly be intentional, well then just for you, I have saved my best piece of evidence for
this. Ooh, okay.
Are you ready? While SpongeBob sings the Goofy
Okay.
song, we cut to him standing on the world and getting abducted by a UFO. And even the UFO's lights make a pattern of red, yellow, red, which is eerily similar to the Goofy Goober UFO that has two red cherries with a yellow
one
in the middle.
Holy
and
crap!
That is the Goofy Goober alien death cult theory.
Okay. All right, here we go. Is that SpongeBob? Yeah, it is. Hey.
Hey.
Wow. Didn't think I could, make these theories any darker, could ya? Gotta love that good old family-friendly PG-rated SpongeBob.
Yeah.
I am having so much fun making these videos. Don't worry, we've got plenty more on the way. I'm just making SpongeBob stuff from now on. I've been your host, Alex the SpongeBob Guy. Thank you so much for watching.
Wait.
I will see you next time.
Ah, here we go. I was waiting for it. I was like, eh?
Assume you're still down here. I thought about what you asked, and I'm sorry, I just can't. I mean, it's one thing to buy you meat, but a living animal, like a cat, that's not a line that I'm willing to cross. And if that means you're not gonna give me SpongeBob theories anymore, then so be it.
I love that, though.
Honestly, man, good luck finding someone else that's going to be willing to be a part of whatever this weird relationship is between us. Come on. I know you can hear me.
Jump scare? Ooh, okay. What was that?
What did you do?
My boy, I took what you brought me.
No, but I changed my mind. I didn't give you the cat.
You purchased the cat. You brought it to this home. I simply finished the job.
No, this is not what I wanted, okay? This isn't worth it. We are done.
Oh. Is it 7? Yep.
My boy, we both know you can't go back now.
Dude, I love that message.
Okay. This is the last time, and then I want you out of this house.
Oh! Okay, you see some of it? Yeah. So honestly, this was a good video. I liked it. I actually liked it. Honestly, I think the story parts are more interesting than the actual theory. I will say that I do think the theory is a little bit of a stretch, even with that ending bit. Like, it's funny how he does mention that, but I still think it is a little bit of a stretch, and I am very skeptical of it. While there is evidence to prove it, there is, you know, I feel like a lot of it could just be like, all these are throwaway gags. But the movie isn't. The analyzing the movie is pretty interesting, how it's like each scene kind of actually goes back towards it or like correlates with it, which that's kind of interesting. But yeah, honestly, I'd say that I really enjoyed it. The story beats were very interesting. I love what's going on here. I cannot wait to see more of what Alex has in store for this whole, like, story thing that's going on. I'm really interested, honestly. I am really interested. But, yeah, anyways, guys, if you guys enjoy, like, the video, subscribe to my channel. See you next one. Bye!